The New Zealand sea lions are one of the rarest species of sea lions in the world, and there's only around about 12,000 individuals left in New Zealand.
One of the things that we've known about Campbell Island is that they do have really high pup mortality there. We believe it's potentially exposure.
We've been talking now for a couple of years about constructing a shelter that would help provide some coverage.
We needed to address the remote environment, the wind and elements.
So we're in Cape Palliser. We're just past it, quite close to the lighthouse. We're going to go down to the site, to the location where we're going to put the shelter.
This is a very special area. We welcome you here. We're very happy for us all to be here and attempting to see if we can do something better for those sea lions, you know, down in Southern Oceans.
Isn't that beautiful? It's raw and it's active, it's strong. This time of year is always beautiful on a coastline.
And there's seals everywhere.
Which is the key.
So we're here down at Cape Palliser, and we've got one of the largest fur seal colonies here in the North Island. And what we're doing is we're trialling a shelter that we've designed for the New Zealand sea lion pup, where due to exposure, we have a high mortality rate.
Well, we've just got some seals just playing in the waves down here.
Here at Cape Palliser, the pups at the moment are around about the same size of your New Zealand sea lions, so they're a great trial for us to see how they use the shelter, investigate it, and hopefully seek shelter as well. Working with the sea lions and seals at the zoo for the last 12 years has really given me that experience, and knowing them behaviourally, working closely with them, has benefited me hugely in sort of contributing to this conservation. You know, I can't wait to see this and where this might head to. Knowing that there's a population of sea lions in decline, it'll be really satisfying to see if this makes a difference. In the early 1800s, due to the sealing, the sea lions were wiped from the mainland. And it's only just in the last decade we're actually having sea lions make a return back to Otago. Some of the biggest threats that face our New Zealand sea lions is competition in terms of food resources. You know, your mum can go away for a day or more to actually fill her belly with some food and then come back and feed her pup. But throughout that time when the mum sea lion is away from her pup, the pups are exposed to some very harsh conditions.
My name's Laura Boren. I'm from the Department of Conservation. I work in the Mountains to Sea team focusing on marine mammals, and in particular the New Zealand Sea Lion Threat Management Plan. One of the things that we've known about Campbell Island is that they do have really high pup mortality there. One year it was around 75 to 80% mortality at Davis Point. And then the following year, it was even higher, 89% at Davis Point, 81% for Campbell Island as a whole. So that was kind of a wake-up call. We wanted to try to do something to help pups get over this hump so that they can be the insurance policy for the population. We believe it's potentially exposure. In early January, when the pups still don't quite have a lot of blubber layer to keep themselves warm, and the area that they live in is a really flat, exposed, kind of rock and boggy platform with not a lot of cover for them. So that's kind of what brought about all the work on the pup shelters. We decided to run an engineering challenge. We needed to address the remote environment, the wind and elements, as well as the fact that adults might try to brush up against it, climb on top of it, and that sort of thing.
Cameron, good to see you.
Yeah, you too.
It's probably easier for you. Warren. Yeah, it's probably easier to introduce yourself.
We've met. I'm Brad. Cameron.
I thought it was just a real awesome opportunity for collaboration with DOC and Auckland Zoo and maybe communities, but also with designers and engineers. It's now. Now is the time to work to try to reverse those trends. And collaborations in this way, as well as the science and doing the field work, all come together to understand the difficult and challenging situation that our New Zealand sea lions face.
We can have a look.
Yeah.
I'm very excited.
Yeah.
Very excited, eh?
Yeah.
So nice to see it for the first time.
I think I've probably got the greatest job on the planet, to be honest. Everything I've done is basically an apprenticeship to come and work at the zoo. In regards to this particular project, I've been involved with it for about the last 12 to 18 months. My speciality is actually design. The real key was to follow the brief that Doc could put out, making sure it was transportable, easily carried, easily put together, easily pulled apart, and could withstand the conditions, and that at the end of the day, it could protect the pups.
When you got your bedding, that's going to go over top of it.
In the design, it was very important to have a number of apertures where they could enter and exit. And blocking can happen for all sorts of reasons. It's just because a bull has just decided to park itself at the front door. But for this way, we have a number of different ways for the pups to get in and out.
Although I've been involved in conservation projects at Auckland Zoo, this is the first one that I've been integrally involved in. And I see myself as pulling the right people together. We have Odin, who's just an awesome seal keeper, and his wealth of knowledge of the New Zealand sea lions. And working with Roger Drew in terms of making our knowledge of the sea lions come to life in a shelter and getting a prototype ready. We got together and started looking at all the various shapes, the various options, but the one that really got us excited was the A-frame style design, which is the one that we've managed to work towards building a prototype.
Cool, heaps of
that's room. Really good, isn't it?
It's clear, right?
Space.
Yeah.
How many pups do you think will?
Well, I've actually designed it for nine, but I think we've got more than nine in there.
Yeah.
So the design of this was to actually set it up in such a way that it became a small city, that became a series of windbreaks that the animals can then shelter in behind if they could not get into the shelter itself. Dotmar produces this particular uni board. This material, that's a reusable, recyclable product, can last up to 100 years in an environment, can then be broken down and be reused again, can withstand high temperatures or low temperatures. In fact, when it goes to the Auckland Island, they're extremely low.
So, free from the fixings, two people can carry this?
Yeah,
cool.
Where my expertise came in was thinking, I guess, behaviourally how sea lions would use this shelter. Males can get up to around about 450 kgs in size. So we wanted something that would deter them from climbing on top of it, because they love climbing. But also, if they were to, that would actually support the weight of a 450 kg male sea lion.
Stella Projects, they're actually a design company who have done a lot of work for the zoo. They actually then provided their expertise to test the shelter. We took a forklift. We actually then attached a 450 kg bag of sand onto the forklift and basically dropped it onto the top of the shelter.
Pretty good,
huh? I'm pretty confident that it'll put up a lot more weight than that.
Yeah.
Basically, the test today consisted of loading this bag of sand on the side and on the top, and the results were really good. There was no extensive flexure of the elements. The fixings held up really well, and when we dismantled it afterwards, there were no signs of any damage. It would be able to withstand that and probably a great deal more weight. I have a big passion for conservation, and I really love what they're doing. It's a great project. It's not your run-of-the-mill engineering at all.
Just pop these here. We brought the shelter to the zoo, and we had quite an amusing time putting it together.
Ready?
As we got going and putting it together, we really started to think, well, actually, yes, we could do this on the beach. We could do this in Campbell Island.
Yep.
Better?
Cool. Nine fingers. We've actually learned a lot today, but there's obviously some changes that need to be made and some little fine tuning.
Yeah, I think, you know, we've got a well thought out design, but when it's in the field, you know, we're going to really see what it's capable of.
We knew we weren't going to be able to trial it on sea lions, as there's only about 20 or so pups born on the mainland every year. New Zealand fur seal pups in winter are about the same size as a sea lion pup. in January. So we decided we might use those, and then we might also get some bad weather to go with it. So we started looking at potential colonies where we could trial this, and started talking about the Cape Palliser colony. I quite liked it because of the south-facing element. It should hopefully be exposed and get some really strong winds and storms through here. I was able to meet with the local mana whenua and pull together a proposal that was then taken to the marae for discussion and consideration.
So after all the collaboration that we've done, really looking forward to actually now going down to Cape Palliser. We're ready to pack up and go. We've got all the details sorted. The unit's been made, has been transported down, and we're ready to jump on a plane and disappear down there.
Ko Aorangi, ko Nawaka Kupe oku manga, ko Turonga Nui, ko Huongaro oku awa, ko Kahanunu, ko Rangitane oku iwi, ko Ngāti Hikawera, ko Ngāti Haniwaka oku hapu, ko Kuhanui te marae, ko Treza Aporo toku ingoa. Ngāti Haniwaka is a coastal hapu that is the lower eastern coast of North Island. It is a hapu of significant of fishing areas on the coast. Since the return of the Lighthouse Reservation, we've been able to establish a footing here to be able to do more protection and research on the area. We were able to have a proper name recognised, Mātakitaki a Kupe, the gazing site of Kupe. And of course the significance of that is that Kupe was one of our founding navigators of this whenua, not just here but New Zealand. The place is a real special place for me, you know, because our father used to bring us out here and I learned to swim there. And I never knew what that sacredness was until I learned about Kupe, so that's why it's special to me. It's a beautiful place.
So we're in Cape Palliser, or just past it, quite close to the lighthouse. We're just meeting Doc now.
Yeah, now I can hear the pups. Exciting.
This is a very special area. We welcome you here. And thank you, Laura, for choosing this and for doing it in the way that meets our tikanga. And we're very happy for us all to be here and attempting to see if we can do something better for those sea lions down in, you know, down in Southern Oceans.
Tau aki au ki tētou nei kōrua tipua kōrua tahitu. Ngarui I runga, ngarui I raro. Ngarui te hua tāne, te hua tāne, ko taku waka ko tāki timi. Ini mea te wako o tirari, ini mea te wako o tirara, ini mea te wako o rongo kako, ini mea te wako o tamate, mai tawhiti, haramai te toki, haumi e hui e
tāiki.
My learning from mana whenua, the way that they are so knowledgeable about the environment and the history of this area is just amazing. I'm learning more and more about how intrinsically linked they are to their environment and the animals that dwell in it, and how open and giving and generous they are with their knowledge. We have travelled from Auckland today with three, myself, Odin and Roger, who are the I suppose pup shelter, three amigos. And we've travelled down first to Wellington and then driven 2 and a bit hours across the hills, across the mountains to Cape Palliser. We're going to go down to the site, to the location where we're going to put the shelter, and just kind of have a look, particularly look at the tide level and
see where the tide's coming in. We know it's about to come up to high tide, so just want to check the spot where we're putting the shelter tomorrow morning to make sure our shelter's not going to get washed away.
He's got his eye on us, look.
Yeah. Just open.
Yeah.
Nothing.
No rock formations.
No rock formation, to stop Solely winds coming through.
So the couple of key things we're looking at, one, that it's going to have enough weather acting on it, you know, the kind of prevalent winds, as much rain and wind that can be thrown at it, so we can really test its robustness. So they'll see it, they're inquisitive, they're curious, and also it's giving us a lot of confidence that if it's not working for them, they can actually go back to their normal shelters and be comfortable. I'm hoping this is something that we're going to be very lucky if we get a lot of this stuff coming through. The only time we don't want it is when we're putting the thing together, right? And then once that's happened, we can get all the technology in there, the cameras, the recording equipment, and then we can actually stand back, start observing, and then let it rain, let it pour, let it blow. We want this to have as much of a test as possible. And so are we wet enough?
You're sure as hell wet enough.
We're gonna call it a day now. I think it's really gonna start pouring.
Yeah. What we'd like to see is this doesn't kind of finish at the Auckland Islands or the Campbell Island. We're quite specific around trying to actually document this and hopefully get the design right that can actually then be used by people that want to get out there and, you know, assist wildlife in the wild.
I love all the pinniped species, the fur seals and the sea lions. I started my research on fur seals to be able to protect them, to be able to teach people about how special they are and see the excitement and the joy in their faces gives me such a good feeling because it's how much I love them too.
It's the day.
It's a beautiful day.
Actually seeing it in place is super exciting.
What do you think? It's a lion job.
To work on one project.
Awesome.
For one.
Very good.
Goal.
Absolutely elated, to be honest.
It just feels special that we can share this with others and supporting the ecology around here.
Hi guys.
Looking forward to it. Looking forward to tomorrow.
The seals will probably love it.